So here's my plan. It's basically based on sacred geometry. As you can see, the concept, it's written over here. So I explained sacred geometry, what it is. So I really like the concept of a seven petal school, like how each and every petal represents something and how the areas are divided on the basis of interests of students. So I'm from India. I'll tell you, in India, it's basically like kids are taught more about, So I'm from India. So in India, education system is more about learning maths and science even today. It's like, I always wanted to become a football player. I never really thought of becoming an architecture student before becoming an architect. So I always wanted to be a football student. But schools, they don't really provide you with the facilities over here. So we're still looking forward to places where we can actually go and learn how to develop in all the other fields as well, other than academics. So obviously when I read about seven petal school, I wanted to design one so that one gets constructed in India, so that the mindset changes slightly over here. So yeah, that's my plan. So in this plan, as you can see over here, yeah, there are like seven petals. It forms like a shell kind of structure, which is based on sacred geometry. So each part of the shell, each petal, it has its own significance, as we were like told. So over here, the blue part, it's the physical and kinetic development shell. So physical and kinetic development, kinetic learners are active learners, and being active is very important. Teaching kids to sit quietly and stay put is a part of learning, but it's often forgotten that they need to learn to be active. As I think Mr. Tesuka, Architect Tesuka sir, so he told us kids need to run. They can't just stand at one place. You can't just ask them to stand at one place and do something. So they need to run, they need space. So throughout the plan, I've like tried as much as possible to provide as many open spaces as possible, because they need it, right? I mean, it's not like you can just provide a building in a school and then just ask them to go over there and learn all the academic stuff. They need to be like, we need to provide them with some activities. So here, yeah, in this one, so I've provided over here, so this one has this OAT. So India is very famous for yoga, I think you will be knowing. So yoga was originated from India. So I've provided a yoga place separately. There's an open air theater over here for yoga. And then there's this garden space. Over here, I've provided trees, like as many trees as possible, so that kids can just go free climbing, or they can perform like other activities, like we can just like attach rides to them. And then there are green spaces where they can play football or any other sport. And then there's this camping site over here. So basically the motto behind the camping site was that kids actually learn to create their own, like to make their own tents, and then they can share ideas, and then they can just like play together, stand their own tents all by themselves, which will help obviously in like the dev. Okay. Yeah. And then every shell, it has these blocks over here, as you can see, the multi-purpose halls. They're like just halls with, they can have classrooms or they can have any other facilities. So all of these have like tried to design them so that they support sustainable development. So basically all the roofs, they should have the skylights for natural daylight, and which will basically help conserving electricity and everything. And then they'll have a lot of openings for ventilation and all that. So basically this is how a typical thing can look like. It's like entirely made of glass, so there's natural daylight coming in. Did it stop? 1 second. Yeah. Yeah. So this is how they can look like. So there's a lot of natural daylight coming in, and then there is a lot of area for kids to discuss and to learn different things. And then comes the... Okay, about kinetic development again. Yeah, so kinetic kinetic development can actually help you learn a lot of other subjects too in a way. I mean, just try throwing a ball and catching it while counting or adding or subtracting the amount of baskets a child can make while playing basketball. It's like all mathematics, and then I think, yeah, okay. 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 You can see it, right? So now we come to the second petal. So the second petal is about articulated and cognitive development. So cognitive development is basically, over here we want to teach kids how to articulate feelings, ideas. They need to learn a mature way of thinking, and we need to introduce kids to new learning methods by providing them with museums, planetariums, exhibition spaces, etc. So over here, I've provided a planetarium right here. It's like this one, a circular planetarium. And then there's a block over here, this block. So this block, it can have a lab room, it can have a library. So library, like obviously where kids can go read and basically they'll learn more. So reading makes people mature. That's like one thing. So it will help in the cognitive development basically. And then... Yeah. So now we come to the third petal. So the third petal was about social and multicultural development. So social and multicultural development, obviously we need to provide kids with as many spaces where they can meet and discuss and socialize basically. So over here it consists of like many open spaces, like in every other petal we have provided. For example, you can see over here these gray parts over here. They are all the meeting spaces for the kids. Like open spaces where they can actually socialize and talk to each other and play and discuss and everything. So open meeting spaces, they can have the benches, they can have all these kiddish cabins. So, and then there are these blocks with the meeting rooms again. Okay, and then the fourth one, we come to aesthetic development. So aesthetic development, basically, yeah, kids will learn how to paint, kids will learn many activities like music and dance and other artistic stuff. So it's like all related to how a kid can actually develop in a professional, for those professional courses, like even architecture is a professional course. If a kid is like learning, is good at art and has a creative mindset, then they can like get into architecture probably. So yeah, and then these over here we have outdoor spaces where they can go and paint and everything. And then over here is this will be like a hall in which we can provide like basically the roof such that the music or the sounds over there get echoed properly. So that can be used like the music or the art hall. And then the fifth one over here is ecological development. So ecological development, basically we have this can be like a greenhouse building is what I thought. And then we have bio gardens. So all these sort of like small gardens over here. So we can like ask kids to go over there and like crop their own plants and then watch them grow. And then we came to the second one. Thank you. And then we come to the sixth petal over here. So that's like hands-on development. So there are workshop spaces basically where kids can go for different workshops. There's a cooking workshop, there are all these earthwork workshops and everything. So they learn, they interact and they learn together. So basically all these are like the workshop spaces again. And then the seventh one is for personal development. So there are quiet hall spaces, and then where they can learn music, or it can be for any other purpose as well. It's all about personal development over here. So this was about the seven petals. And then also there's like a centrally located swimming pool for obviously kids can just go over there for as it can also be a part of kinetic development again. And then coming to the bioclimatic design that I've tried using everywhere, it's like, yeah, use of skylights obviously, and the use of jali walls are like pretty famous in India actually. So if I am designing the school from India, I'll definitely make use of jali walls. And then yeah, trees in abundant, as many as possible, because they obviously provide us with Tyndall effect and then shade and everything. So yeah, kids can work in shade. And then there are these solar panel trees all over the site, which will obviously provide electricity to the entire school. And kids, when they look at it, they'll get to know, I mean, how sustainable development works and how they can generate electricity through different ways.